Item number, SCP-037. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. SCP-037 is magnetically contained in a subterranean complex, known as Site-22. Object size, spectral signature, and temperature are constantly monitored both on-site and remotely from Site-98. The primary containment chamber is lined with heat-conducting, radiation-resistant, nanopeak GFV polymer tiles, and evacuated of any atmosphere. Heat from the object is radiated into the surrounding rock. Should enclosure integrity become compromised, the emergency system will generate a low-power argon plasma shield. This is projected to provide a minimum of 4 hours for our on-site engineers to effect necessary repairs before the object breaches containment. In the contingency that stellar evolution proceeds ahead of projections and a Nova event appears imminent, or if containment failure is otherwise unavoidable, any remaining project staff are authorized to initiate the PITWAC protocol. Description: SCP-037 appears to be a star, approximately 5 centimeters or 2 inches in diameter, with a luminosity of about 1 to the power of 10 to 12 times that of our Sun, and a surface temperature of about 5,000 Kelvin, determined by UBVRI analysis. The origin of SCP-037 is unknown. However, analysis suggests that it shares many properties in common with a typical main-sequence star, other than its anomalously small size. It is theorized to have entered the Earth's magnetosphere via the North Magnetic Pole. The object was discovered in 19... above the Beaufort Sea at approximately the North Magnetic Pole. Intense electromagnetic interference was reported by Canadian Forces Station, CFS, alert, followed by an extremely bright object descending towards the ocean from the sky. The SCPS Guardian responded and discovered the object wavering in an erratic trajectory about 200 meters above the surface of the water. Once containment procedures were devised, it was transported to Site-32 for study. Containment and transport of SCP-037 have been achieved by the use of powerful electromagnets to which the artifact aligns itself according to its own magnetic field. The primary challenge to containment thus far has been its powerful electromagnetic emissions, which are intense enough to be easily seen by the naked eye from high Earth orbit. Its current enclosure is located deep underground to prevent detection and to facilitate radiative cooling into the surrounding bedrock. In effect, the entire facility and the surrounding volume of the Earth's crust act as a massive heat sink. Addendum A. Over the past years of study, the star has undergone a shift and emitted EM radiation, suggesting that it is undergoing stellar evolution at a vastly accelerated rate. If standard stellar models hold up, this will soon result in an increase in radius by a factor of 100 to 300 times, and a concomitant increase in radiated energy. Emergency containment contingencies are being studied for that eventuality. Further progression of the star's life cycle will likely terminate in a stellar nova, which is estimated to have a yield of... Extrapolations predict this to occur and... Research is underway for a method to arrest this development or to transport SCP-037 a safe distance from the planet before it occurs. Item number, SCP-121. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. Containment Site-83 has been established outside SCP-121. To house personnel dedicated to the containment of SCP-121. The perimeter of SCP-121 is to remain fenced off from the surrounding area, with guards stationed along the perimeter at all times. Guards are to don local military uniforms and remain heavily armed at all times. Rotation of guards is to occur every 4 hours. The surrounding population is to remain informed that SCP-121 is quarantined due to persisting hazardous material. Warning signs are to be placed 75, 50, and 25 kilometers out along roads leading to SCP-121 to deter trespassers. Civilians who approach the perimeter of SCP-121 are to be reminded of the quarantine and forced to depart. Those who resist are to be detained for questioning. In the event that approaching civilians witness an active instance of SCP-121-1 or 2, Class A amnestics are to be administered. Any meteorological data regarding SCP-121's anomalous effect is to be censored, and SCP-121 has been labeled a no-flight zone to prevent knowledge of SCP-121, 1, and 2. Site Task Force Iota 71, Home Wreckers, has been established and permanently assigned to Containment Site 83 in response to the threat of SCP-121-2. They are to escort researchers interested in studying non-hostile instances of SCP-121-2, as well as neutralize any instances that have grown to potentially lethal sizes. In the event of an attempted containment breach, Iota 71 is to assist perimeter guards in the neutralization of the instance of SCP-121-2. Any buildings within SCP-121 that develop into SCP-121-1 are to be recorded and monitored at all times for transition into SCP-121-2. Instances of SCP-121-2 that become innately hostile upon transition are to be neutralized. However, passive instances may continue to dwell within the perimeter of SCP-121 for research purposes until they've grown to a size too dangerous to contain or become hostile, at which point they are to be neutralized. Description: SCP-121 is the region of land occupied by the former town of Colorado. The town was home to roughly 6,800 prior to enactment of current containment protocol and holds roughly 3,000 buildings, both residential and commercial. Clouds above SCP-121 appear incapable of entering an area roughly 12 kilometers in diameter, instead passing around the area. It is speculated this is related to SCP-121's range of effect, but it is not known how at this time. Buildings in SCP-121 will sporadically, no more than one at a time, with 3 weeks minimum between manifestation, detach from any foundations and ascend into the air. At this point, these buildings are identified as SCP-121-1. Instances of SCP-121-1 ascend to a random height of a minimum of 45 meters. Regardless of the previous state of the building, doors and windows become locked, and any potential entryways become barricaded by furniture inside. Forced entry has shown an increased ambient temperature of roughly 35 degrees Celsius and a relative humidity of roughly 65%, but a lack of any further anomalous properties. Instances of SCP-121-1 will cease suspension after a minimum period of 10 weeks, but may remain airborne for no more than 15 weeks afterwards. Instances do not show any abnormal levels of durability, and near total destruction of SCP-121-1 upon impact with the ground is common. After impact, the remains of instances of SCP-121-1 will contain an ovoid object, approximately 1.2 meters by 1.2 meters by 2 meters, composed of materials consistent with furniture found inside the home. Examination of mostly intact instances of SCP-121-1 show an absence of previous furnishings. The object will begin to locomote on its own accord. At this point, it will be referred to as SCP-121-2. SCP-121-2 begin to form a conglomerate with nearby materials, including debris from SCP-121-1, flora, automobiles, and, on rare occasion, other buildings. SCP-121-2 will continue to attract objects until it forms a body of material 9 meters in height, at which point the body will animate and appear to take on levels of sentience. SCP-121-2 may, at this point, begin to simulate ingesting other material to continue growing at a considerably slower rate. Ingestion appears to be for the sole purpose of continued growth, as instances have gone prolonged periods of time without material. Certain items have been known to attach to SCP-121-2 instantaneously, despite size and the lack of simulated ingestion. Instances of SCP-121-2 normally resemble animals, capable of locomotion on land, but have been known to take on humanoid forms, and forms that do not resemble any known animal. They are primarily docile, and normally do not display hostility towards personnel unless provoked. However, SCP-121-2 instances have been known to form with innate aggressive and territorial behavior. This behavior has also been observed to develop following the accumulation of certain items, including firearms, bladed weapons, and in one example, the taxidermy head of a bear. SCP-121 came to the attention of the Foundation when local authorities were flooded with reports of a previously abandoned residence suddenly flying in the sky. The town was evacuated under the guise of a hazardous material spill, and the residence was observed. Once the instance of SCP-1211 transitioned into SCP-1212, SCP-1212 was quickly neutralized. Following the neutralization, another instance of SCP-1211 developed, and the town was permanently evacuated and contained. This is the only occasion on which the creation of SCP-1211 has so closely followed the creation of an instance of SCP-1212. Incident 121A. On 11/04/98, a sound, described as a muffled siren, was heard for approximately 5 minutes. An active instance of SCP-1211 was suddenly subject to an immense force following the sound, causing the building to prematurely break apart while suspended, before the 10-week minimum. Neighboring towns reported hearing the sound. Local press were informed quarantine staff were being evacuated due to a temporary elevation in toxic levels. The cause of the sound is currently unknown. Further research is recommended. 3 weeks following the sound and the destruction of SCP-1211, the remains finally fell to the ground. Inside the rubble were remnants of the ovoid object found in SCP-1212, along with traces of aluminum slag. Incident 121B. On 05/09/12, a 1991 Dodge Caravan was found suspended 53 meters in the air. Internal surveillance is at this time impossible, due to the windows being obscured by what appears to be wool cloth. Further observation of the vehicle is recommended. Item number, SCP-149. Object Class, Keter. Special Containment Procedures. SCP-149, in any of its instances, is to be kept inside a sealed plexiglass box for observation. Oxygen and a nutrient mist are to be released into the containment cell every 2 hours. If any instance of SCP-149 escapes its cell, Protocol 42 Charlie is to be brought into effect on any and all contaminated personnel by order of 05/12 after Incident 149-1. Description: SCP-149 is a breed of mosquito which carries a strain of retrovirus, herein referred to as SCP-149A. That mutates regenerating human cells into fertilized mosquito eggs. SCP-149A is injected directly into the bloodstream when SCP-149 feeds. The SCP-149A quickly works on the nucleus of the cells, warping the DNA. The first set of cells bred from these changed instructions closely resemble cysts and are concentrated in the lining of the esophagus and the sinuses. Upon dissection, however, these cysts are revealed to be filled with SCP-149's larva, the cysts acting as a protective casing against external forces. SCP-149 appears to go through its maturation cycle in a matter of hours. By the time the subject is able to feel any effects, the first generation of SCP-149 has already grown inside the subject's body. SCP-149 primarily achieves exodus through the mouth and nostrils, occasionally being diverted through the sphenoid sinuses to escape through the eye sockets. Infection by SCP-149 is fatal, and chance of infection has been estimated to be 50% from one bite. Addendum, Incident 149-1. An incidence of SCP-149 escaped and infected multiple Class D subjects, the majority of whom did not report SCP-149's contact with them. Within 5 hours, SCP-149 had matured in these hosts and burst out of them, infecting several staff members. It was only thanks to the quick thinking of Dr. who sealed sublevels 12 through 15 that the entire site was not infected. As a response to this, O5 Command has created Protocol 42 Charlie, to be used if SCP-149 escapes confinement. Item number, SCP-160. Object Class, Euclid. Special Containment Procedures. SCP-160 is kept in a secure biocontainment chamber at site. SCP-160 is to be fed live prey in the form of a rabbit or other animal of similar mass once per week. with feeding to be performed via automated delivery system only. Experimentation with SCP-160 may only be performed with prior permission from at least two Level 3 personnel, and any personnel entering the chamber must wear an armored suit at all times. Description: SCP-160 appears to be a quadriflyer unmanned aerial vehicle, or UAV, with a diameter of approximately 1.1 meters at its widest point, similar to the model manufactured by the corporation. It is devoid of any identifying marks or manufacturing labels, though visual inspection of SCP-160 has revealed signs of scratches and other superficial damage, indicating that prior identifying labels may have been removed. SCP-160 operates continuously and completely autonomous from any identified control source, and exhibits behavior similar to that of predatory birds. It will actively hunt prey such as rodents and other small animals, and, upon locating such prey, dive down at high speed and impale its prey with what appears to be a metallic proboscis. Analysis of its prey shows that it then injects a highly caustic substance that liquefies the internal organs and extracts the resulting slurry. SCP-160 will generally avoid humans and larger animals, but has been recorded using its proboscis in self-defense. Injuries inflicted by SCP-160 are extremely painful and can cause death via liquefaction of vital organs or internal bleeding. Further research on SCP-160 is underway, but has proven difficult due to SCP-160's continuous operation. Tranquilizer darts are ineffective, as SCP-160 appears to be entirely composed of non-biological components, and requests to attempt a low-intensity electromagnetic pulse to disable it have been rejected due to possible unforeseen damage. SCP-160 was discovered by Foundation agents in 2000 following multiple reports of household pets from the town of Data Expunged disappearing and subsequently being found dead under unusual circumstances. SCP-160 was quickly identified and lured into a transport vehicle by a containment team, and subsequently taken to site. A search of the area turned up several desiccated small animals, including house cats, rabbits, wild rodents, and miniature dogs. Item number: SCP-199. Object class: Plant. Containment class: Euclid. Special containment procedures: A garden of SCP-199 has been built at Site-19 for research and containment. The garden is kept in a ventilated containment unit with artificial light suitable for plant growth and an automatic watering system. The ceiling is covered with an electrified grate capable of destroying instances of SCP-199-2. The entire chamber is to be surrounded with a Faraday cage to prevent emission of SCP-199-3. Instances of SCP-199 or SCP-199-2 found outside of containment are to be destroyed with fire or pesticides. Description: SCP-199 is a species of fern within the Hymenophyllaceae family. SCP-199 is tangentially related to filmy ferns, but is more tolerant to temperature, humidity, pollution, and external damage. The rhizomes of the plants can attach to and grow on most solid surfaces. SCP-199's appearance is similar to that of Thallos liverworts, but its fronds are unique to its species. The fronds of SCP-199 will form into bladders approximately 10 centimeters in diameter, designated SCP-199-2. Eventually, they will fill with hydrogen gas generated by SCP-199, detach from the main plant, and drift into the air. SCP-199-2 will eventually float at 1 mile above sea level and begin to ripen. During this period, SCP-199-2 will emit SCP-199-3 at an initial rate of 1 signal per hour, steadily increasing as SCP-199-2 ripens. Once SCP-199-2 is ripe, it will burst, releasing its contents. In most cases, SCP-199-2 is empty, and its explosion will not have any consequences. Occasionally, The explosion of SCP-199-2 will release seeds that grow into new instances of SCP-199. SCP-199-3 refers to radio signals produced by SCP-199-2. All radio signals consist of a high-pitched male voice, speaking in Mandarin Chinese, giving analysis reports, consisting of observations made from SCP-199-2 and status reports of SCP-199-2 itself. Analysis of SCP-199-2 has shown that neither the source of the voice nor the radio signals exist, as most instances of SCP-199-2 are empty. SCP-199 seems to thrive in polluted environments, implying that it is adapted to grow in heavily populated areas. In addition, SCP-199 is resistant to most pesticides. SCP-199 is most commonly seen growing in chimneys, gardens of large cities, and inside of industrial factories. SCP-199 was originally discovered after residents of Xi'an, China reported balloon-like objects colliding with hotels and interference with radio devices. The source of SCP-199-2 was found to be a patch of it within the center of the city. Instances of SCP-199 have been since discovered in several large cities, most notably New York City, Los Angeles, San Francisco, Beijing, and Tokyo. Analysis of SCP-199-3. From 09-12-2017 to 09-19-2017, large-scale analysis of SCP-199-3 was conducted by the Foundation. Large containment cell number 45 at Site 9 was temporarily converted into a simulated urban area. 5 instances of SCP-199 were moved to the area for testing. The following is a transcript of SCP-199-3 transmissions, as well as notes in italics. This is Staff Man Foxtail, launch successful, entering watching mode. Transcript of SCP-199-3 after launch of SCP-199-2. Name and rank vary per instance. Targets found, beginning following mode. Transcript of SCP-199-3 after floating above simulated civilians. Targets performing clumping, engaging. Targets entering phase, engaging. Transcript of SCP-199-3 after floating above a gathering of simulated civilians. Engaging in Armageddon. Transcript of SCP-199-3 after floating above a gathering for 2 minutes. Armageddon failed. Disengaging. Transcript of SCP-199-3 after floating above a gathering for 5 minutes. It is unknown what would occur if Armageddon was successful. Evasive drift initiated. Course moved. Obstacle encountered. Moving from course. Transcript of SCP-199-3 while avoiding buildings. Single target engaged in protectionless. Retreating. Transcript of SCP-199-3 after floating above a member of D-class personnel, disguised as a New York citizen on a balcony. Single target engaged in that of protection. Standing by. Transcript of SCP-199-3 after floating above a member of D-class personnel disguised as a New York citizen on a balcony, while the balcony had flowers. Non-target found without that of protection, colored blue. Transcript of SCP-199-3 after floating above a balcony with flowers without a civilian. Color changed depending on type of flower. Standing position recovered, entering malign phase. After this was recorded, SCP-199-2 instances actively avoided balconies. Unintelligible. The Paragon. Emitted by a contained instance of SCP-199-2 while floating above Site 19. Payload ready for deployment soon. Standing by. SCP-199-3 as SCP-199-2 became close to explosion. Sorry, it looks like we have a mayday here. Please avoid future infertility. SCP-199-3 before explosion, when SCP-199-2 was empty. We have a complete deployment ready. Pleasure to serve you, sir. SCP-199-3 before explosion, when SCP-199-2 had spores. If you could tell them I loved them. One instance of SCP-199-2 emitted this while idle, and appeared to be cut off mid-sentence. Context unknown. Many variations and idle phrases cut out of this document. Addendum. On 09/21/2018, residents of Istanbul, Turkey reported a collective cloud of over 50 instances of SCP-199-2. Before a task force could respond to this, all instances simultaneously burst. Instead of seeds, SCP-199-2 released an acidic slime that caused severe damage to a road intersection and created 3 casualties. An ongoing disinformation campaign was released, crediting the source of SCP-199-2 to be a bioterrorist attack. The source of this phenomenon was identified to be a patch of SCP-199 on the outskirts of Istanbul. The task force attempted to use fire to destroy these plants. However, SCP-199 reacted with the fire and exploded into acidic green slime, injuring 5 Foundation agents. Following destruction of the patch, analysis of the soil revealed that SCP-199 had been planted there 4 weeks earlier. This new variant of SCP-199 has been tentatively designated SCP-199-B. SCP-199-B has also been reported in Mumbai, Lagos, and Mexico City. Near the patch found in Lagos, a partially biodegraded plastic seed packet was recovered buried underground. The front of the packet had a symbol resembling an eye, with a red iris, with a green substance covering a third of the eye. The back of the packet had a symbol strongly resembling the Foundation's shield logo, but with the arrows pointing away from the shield, and 3 vertical bars covering the shield's inner circle. Lesson complete. To continue with your orientation training, subscribe to SCP Orientation right now, and make sure you don't miss any of our upcoming videos.